Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'll show you how you can take better landscape pictures using your Vivo V9. Now, I have already made several videos on Vivo V9 and I've also covered Vivo V9's camera user interface, how you have to use the camera user interface, what are the settings available. But in this particular video, we shall cover the topic landscape photography. Now, there are a couple of things that you should be looking for, you should be tweaking inside the Vivo V9's camera so that you get really awesome landscape pictures. So that is what I'll be showing you. And if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Stay tuned, I am making a lot of interesting videos on this channel. So let's start with the video and what are the things that you should be looking to capture some really good landscape images on your Vivo V9. So guys, this is the typical usual camera interface of the Vivo V9, as you know, and you usually take pictures in take photo mode or you go to the professional mode and snap a picture. That's what you usually do. But the important thing to notice here is to enabling of this grid line. Now, how I have enabled this 3x the grid line is you have to go to the settings, tap here and just enable this framing lines. See, if I remove the framing lines, there is no grid here. And if I enable this framing line, you get the grid. Now you can use this grid as a reference to get really perfect horizontal level images. That way it ensures you a professional like picture every single time. Now if I tilt the camera to left or right, you get some weird angles. That is not a professional thing that you should be taking pictures. But what I suggest you to do is to use this framing line as a reference point and make sure everything is horizontal. Hold the camera steady and then take a picture. This way you will get really good images. The second important thing to enable is the electro level meter. Now Vivo V9 has given you an electro level meter which you can utilize for and get some really good images. Now how to enable that electro level meter is you have to go to the professional mode. So once we are in the professional mode, and here as you can see there is a mark, there is a sign, you just tap on this and boom, there you have the electro level meter. Along with the grid line, you can use the electro level meter as a reference point. And see, as I tilt, it gives me white dotted, which was horizontal, and it says that you are not holding the camera properly in proper angle. So once it turns yellow, now everything is perfect to the horizontal. And when I take the picture, it will be of really nice composition. Now the another thing what you can do is to see that everything is perfectly composited. For example, if I hold the camera like this, this is weird because I'm covering a lot of sky, a lot of blue skies and clouds, but I don't get the detail of what is on the foreground. So you should be looking for the foreground element as well as the background. Everything should be properly visible and properly pleasing to the eye. That way you get really good images. Now as you can see, there is a lot of grass here, and you know that this will be some kind of park, and you know that there are some trees here, some coconut trees, and you know that there is something going on over here, and also there is a blue sky. So all this makes a really beautiful image. So this is how you need to composite the image. The next thing you need to change is the Ultra HD mode. See, if you enable this Ultra HD mode, you will unlock the 63 megapixel of goodness, and make sure you are holding your camera very steadily. And once you take the picture, just hold it in that angle for a couple of seconds. And once you do that, here you get the very detailed picture, which you can take a printout of and hang it on your wall as well. That way it looks really good. So this is how you enable the Ultra HD and take the picture. You enable the electro level meter, you enable the grid lines. Next thing you can do is to compensate the exposure. Say for example, the foreground element is really dark and the clouds and the background element is really lit because of the sun rays falling over that. And what you see here, foreground element is really dark. What you can do now is to just tap on this EV and increase the stop to 0.3 stop or 0.5 or 0.7 depending on the scene. And once you do that, as you can see, it really gets bright, and this is how you compensate the exposure. Even what you can do is while you are in take photo mode, you can just tap on the picture to focus, and here you see the small sun sort of icon here. You just increase the exposure compensation exposure value from here, just increase the slider, move the slider upward and then take a picture in take photo mode. That way you can get some really nice looking images for the foreground as well as the background. So these are the settings that you should be looking for. And one more thing you can do is to enable the HDR. As you know, HDR gives some really nice details in the black shadows as well as in the highlights. So that way you get really nice image as well. So the trick here is to get the grid lines, enable the electro level meter and go to the professional mode, and there you see you changed some of the settings and see that everything is composited perfectly. And even if you change the white balance, if you think the color showing here is not accurate, you tap on this white balance and just see how the colors change here, how the temperature will change. So once you are okay with the color that is showing here, then just tap on the picture and boom, there you have the perfect landscape picture that you are looking for. So guys, these are the settings that you should be looking for on your Vivo V9. I hope it gave you some of the insight on how to take better landscape pictures. So now go ahead and take some really good landscape pictures. Let me know in the comments below. Show me your pictures, how you have taken your landscape images. Let me see it as well. So hopefully you like this video. Hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for more awesome content. See you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.